I still remember the day my father took me to see the legend that would become El Kaiser Chiefs for the first time. It was the early summer of 2004, and we walked through the streets of Blackburn, trapped behind ashen skies as the late afternoon poured over King George's Hall in a wreath of liquid copper. Daniel, we mustn't tell anyone where we're about to see today, my father warned. Not even your friend Thomas. No one. Not even mother, I questioned. My father sighed, hiding behind the sad smile that followed him like a shadow all through his life. Do not tell mother, he answered. Heavy hearted. She likes the end goals. You can tell her nothing of this. Some things can only be seen in the shadows, my father said, flashing a mysterious smile probably borrowed from the pages of one of his worn, damp brown novels that were very popular at the time. Night watchmen lingered in the misty streets when we got closer to King William Street. The lamps along the street marked an avenue in the early evening haze as the city awoke, like a watercolour slowly coming to life. When we reached the crossing, we continued through the arch of the night towards the building, entering a vault of blue haze. I followed my father through a narrow doorway, more of a scar than an entrance, until the glimmer of the real world faded behind us. The brightness of the room filtered down from balconies and cornices in streaks of slanting light that dissolved before touching the ground. At last, my father stopped in front of the stage, blackened by time and humidity. Before us loomed what to my eyes seemed the carcass of a palace of echoes and shadows. Daniel, you mustn't tell anyone what you're about to see tonight, not even your friend Thomas. No one. Welcome to the world of El Kaiser Chiefs.
entertain you. If you go home unentertained, we have not done our job. So, ladies and gentlemen, one more time, let me hear it for the Kaiser Chiefs.
Saying nothing is cool, so cool to know nothing.